One publication in Maryland has been reporting on commerce, including business, finance, law, construction, and real estate in Baltimore City and county since the late 1800s. The Daily Record is a go-to for many who want to keep up on the latest events and laws that govern business in our state. The paper is also known for its philanthropy and especially recognizing women in business for the last 25 years through a special event that highlights their achievements in these areas. Joining me this morning to talk about how the pandemic has affected them as a local business, how they will continue to honor women in business this year, and how you can attend is the publisher and founder of Maryland's Top 100 event, Suzanne Fischer-Huettner. Good morning, Suzanne. Welcome to Maryland Perspectives.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on, Amelia.
The Daily Record is a great source of business and law news, like I was saying, and it keeps everybody up on how the pandemic has affected local businesses. Now, as a local business yourself, how have you been affected, and especially with the events for the Daily Record that you host each year?
Thank you for asking. Obviously, we are all learning to do business differently due to this pandemic. But the Daily Record hosts more than 15 events a year honoring various types of achievement. And our pinnacle event is Top 100 Women. And this year is our 25th anniversary for this very special event. So we had initially planned to host the gala in April, and obviously that got moved because that was a very stressful time. We moved to the end of July, and we still aren't in a place where we can have 1,000 people in a room together in person. It's just not safe, and I don't even think we'd be able to anyway. So we have moved to a virtual event model. We launched our first virtual event June 1st with influential Marylanders. We have had four more since then. And we're very excited to bring together the women, their families, their coworkers to celebrate excellence on July 27th in a unique virtual way using multimedia storytelling. And it'll be much like you've tuned into a professionally done TV show.
Oh, very cool. That sounds like a lot of back-end production. So you've probably had to bring in some new companies to get that up and running, I would think, especially technologically speaking.
Well, we were very fortunate because we have great event partners. VPC does all of our production work, and Epsilon handles our registration. And when the world changed, we all pivoted together and basically spent the month of April trying to figure out, okay, how do we still honor, celebrate, bring people together, because that's what business people need. We need to still come together, even if it can't be in person. And we sort of built this model from scratch, each of us doing the part we know best. Clearly, my part was more the vision and the bringing together the women and the event. It was not the production side. So, yes, we have an outside production company that's doing all of that.
Now, this year marks the 25th anniversary, like you were saying, of Maryland's Top 100 Women. As a woman, I know how hard it can be, not so much as it was for my mother back in the 60s and 70s of trying to break that glass ceiling. But there's still some obstacles that we need to overcome. Is this one of the reasons why you started the event?
Absolutely. I have also been with the Daily Record 25 years. I, oddly as life would have it, my second day was the very first Top 100 Women. And much like you just explained, I'm not sure I understood how much the women that came before us did to give us the opportunities that we all have today. So that's been an amazing experience for me to be able to be circled by these 100 amazing women every single year. And as the event goes on, you know, originally I think our fear was 100's a lot. Are we going to run out of these high-level, high-achieving women, you know? But the opposite happened. Every year we're getting 500-plus nominations, and oftentimes it takes women numerous years to win because so we pick the winners, and it's done by outside panel of judges based on three criteria: professional achievement, community service, and commitment to mentoring. They have to fulfill all three. Many people can be professionally successful, but it's harder to have that commitment to community service and to mentoring. And it can't be I'm mentoring the person who works next to me. It needs to be true mentoring relationships where you're going above and beyond. So that's how the program came to be. And you're exactly right. At the time it was launched 25 years ago, women weren't being honored in that way. They were really just starting to take the corner office or however we talk about it today, and they weren't on public boards. And, you know, and the world's not perfect today. We know we're all still trying to achieve equality in many ways.
Right.
But it has come a really long way over the past 25 years, and we're proud of the peace that we've had in that and the connections that we've been able to make for these women and for the next generation of leaders.
Well, the criteria that you mentioned, I can see where, especially as a professional businesswoman, you've got a lot of things you've got to do. We always try to overachieve a little bit too. You know, we're bending over backwards, doing a little more than we should. Some of us, not all of us, but I understand that. And so to be able to do that extra mentoring and give extra personal time, this isn't while you're on the job, that's definitely commendable. Have you announced this year's winners?
We have. So we have 100 winners, and then we have 17 women that are going to be inducted into the Circle of Excellence. That's our three-time winners that have sustained the highest level of achievement.
And what types of businesses are they coming from?
Sure. Let me just tell you a few. It really ranges. We have Candace Dobson Reed from UMBC. We have the Baltimore County Police Chief, Melissa Hyatt. Dr. Mary Lou Yam, who is the president of Notre Dame of Maryland University. Deborah Wiener from WBAL.
Yeah, Deborah.
Lisa Rusniak. Yeah, there you go. Lisa Rusniak from Goodwill Industries. Shalonda Stokes, Downtown Partnership.
Nice.
And we cover the state. So Beverly Deering from the Salisbury School in the Eastern Shore. You know, that's another thing we're very proud of, the amount of diversity. And I mean that in every single way, whether it's industry, racial, what counties we're in the state. We've worked really hard to achieve that because we are all pulling together to make a difference. So everyone needs to be recognized for the special piece they have.
There's another, of course, philanthropic element to this, and it's a scholarship that is supported through this event. I believe you're sending college women to further their education. So tell us about this the scholarship and how it's impacted women over the years.
We launched the scholarship, I believe it was 16 years ago. Every year, we ask for nominations from universities to tell us about your outstanding student. We ask them to pick one. And then our Circle of Excellence winners, they actually get to select who gets the scholarship.
Okay.
It's a $3,000 scholarship. At this point, we've already donated over $50,000. And this year's winners from Morgan State University.
Oh, very good. So this isn't gender specific, though. It's anybody who is eligible and is working really hard towards furthering their education.
So it is gender.
It is.
It's held by the same criteria as the Top 100 Women Award. Again, to a different level because they're not as high in their careers yet. But they have to show professional achievement, which would be academic, their community service, and that they're also mentoring other students.
One of the other aspects of this event that I think is amazing, because I realize, and I think a lot of other women realize, heart disease is the number one killer. It's something that we all need to pay attention to. I have high blood pressure, and I've learned a whole lot about it over the last 2 years. So tell us about Go Red for Women and how you're supporting them with this event.
Absolutely. So our team, when we came together to plan the 25th, we really wanted to pick a nonprofit that we could give back to, but also provide help to our winners and our guests by learning more. So we have partnered with Go Red for Women for the entire year of the 25th anniversary. We have continuous coverage in all of our women's products. And, you know, what I've learned, just like you brought up, Amelia, which did shock me, I don't always think of heart disease as the number one killer of women. You know, we hear so many other things affecting women.
Right.
And in reality, one in three women will be affected by heart disease. That's one third of our mothers, sisters, friends. That's a pretty alarming statistic. So at the event, the head of Go Red for Women will, again, because we're not going to be live, but she has done a video that's very interactive, very interesting, to raise awareness and really help women and their families, because obviously this goes well beyond women,
sure,
to be able to live healthier lives, which is what we all want.
Yep, live longer and get to stay and do what we're very passionate about for our entire lives. I completely agree. And I tell you, the American Heart Association, a really great organization for getting the word out. And it doesn't matter what gender you are, or like you said, it's very diversified over how our hearts are probably the most important thing with our health and how the rest of our body affects our heart health. So I'm glad you guys chose them. As you can see, I'm very passionate about it.
Thank you. Thank you.
So let's talk about how people can attend this event, because it sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun to watch. You're going to do it online, and this is a ticketed event, yes?
It is a ticketed event. You can go to thedailyrecord.com, and if you just click on Top 100 Women on our events list, the tickets are $60 a person, and the event is from 5:30 to 7:00. since we can't be together, we're encouraging everyone to watch it in the place that they're comfortable with, you know, their favorite drink, their favorite food, their family, their pets, or whatever is appropriately social distanced, right?
As an aside, let's talk about the Daily Record for a second, too. I know you're on the business end and you're not a journalist. However, how has the pandemic affected your operations?
I think we've all, especially in the media world, which you can fully understand, we've all had to learn to pivot, innovate, and adjust. And, you know, when it comes to news, we have award-winning coverage, which we are very proud of. But our team has worked relentlessly to make sure everybody has the most up-to-date information. You know, when we were all in our homes and nobody was going out, our reporters were out there.
Right.
And because we need to make sure that everybody has the news to keep their businesses moving, themselves safe, their employees safe. And as you know, right now, there's so much news, and we all need to navigate this, and we need to know what is safe for our organization. We hold true to our niche, which is business and legal news, but we all really need to understand how do all these different things affect our businesses. So now if you look at our website, anything's up there from the latest information from Governor Hogan to legal facts about what we need to know to make sure that liabilities that were covered and that we're not going to end up getting sued. I mean, there's just a lot going on right now.
Yeah, and it's hard to make heads or tails of all of it, and it's nice to know that there are some great media outlets, especially locally and locally owned, that are telling our stories and giving us the information we need to function on a daily basis. So thank you for that.
Yeah, we're very proud of that. All of our reporters are local. They're working hard. They're in the midst of everything going on. But it's been hard because, you know, we're all doing a lot more with less. And that's no different than anyone else today.
So let's get that website again where people can get tickets to the Top 100 Women event.
Sure. It's thedailyrecord.com.
Very good. And I saw that on the front page, so it's really easy to find. Suzanne Fischer-Huettner is the publisher of The Daily Record and the founder of the Top 100 Women in Maryland event. I'll make sure I get the links up for tickets and to the paper online on our website, 98online.com/Maryland Perspectives. Thanks, Suzanne, for keeping us informed on important news and our state's business and laws and for recognizing women across the state.
Thank you.